nothing seemed to stop him. For 5 years, he dominated the National League, winning five ERA titles, pitching four no-hitters, winning the Cy Young Award three times. Despite persistent, excruciating pain from an elbow permanently damaged before he had learned to pace himself, Koufax had to apply massive heat to his arm before every game, then plunge it in ice water after it was over. But he did not argue with umpires, did not throw at batters, engaged in no theatrics. "He'll strike you out," an opposing batter said, "but he won't embarrass you."
It's Roger Maris. The windup, Sandy delivers. Swing and a miss.
He pitched a no-hitter every year from 1962 to 1965. In 1965 alone, he struck out 382 batters, 33 more than his nearest competitor, Rube Waddell, had in 1904.
Two and two to Harvey Keene. One strike away. Sandy into his windup. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. A perfect game.
Sandy was at his peak. Batters used the word unfair. I heard them say that. It's an unfair contest after they've been up bat against him. And I remember more than once a batter being up there and looking at that terrific fastball, which always seemed to come up as it crossed the plate, and then shooting a look out to Sandy. What was that? It was as if he'd thrown an Easter egg past him or something like that. It was something different. The game had been altered. And then he had that devastating curve. So the combination of those two, the batters felt absolutely helpless. And he was beautiful to watch because he bent his back in a way that other pitchers didn't. They had this enormous long hands and long arms. And there was a bow and arrow feeling about the way that he used his body.
He had a way of tipping off his pitches. If he was pitching a fastball from the windup, he'd have his elbows out like this before the pitch. And if he was going to pitch a curveball, his elbows would be tucked in against him. So every batter knew exactly what he's going to be doing. Of course, the pitches were so good it didn't make any difference. They couldn't hit either one of them.
Batting now, the second inning, and the Dodgers lead him 4-0. Here's Mickey Mantle. Now the windup by Sandy. He delivers. It's a strike call. The fourth straight strikeout for Sandy Koufax.
Casey Stengel believed him the best pitcher in baseball history. "Forget the other fellow," he said, meaning Walter Johnson. "You can forget Waddell. The Jewish kid is probably the best of them."